Really happy with where we are as a team, where we've come from over the last month, as we kind of close out the non-conference portion of our season. I think we've learned some good lessons along the way. We've played some really good teams. We've tested ourselves well, and really proud of this past weekend. I thought we played with great energy in both games. You know, Friday's game had some interesting adversity with the weather, but I really thought we came out and played with great energy there and dealt with those conditions to the best of our ability. And then to bounce back on Sunday and play a team that was fresh, that was 6-2 on the year and going to do play, you know, going to do really well in their league, to come out and play with great, you know, had a great start, but really closed the game out really well, and just proud of our team for how we finished the weekend as we kind of go into the next portion of our season.
Bianca, how was it to play in those conditions on Friday? Obviously, Brock could describe them as messy going into that game.
Well, like he said, it was very messy, but it definitely brought out our true mental toughness, and we always talk about our core values, and that's one of them, and I thought we did really well and handled it really well all around the field, defense, offense, midfield, goalie.
And then on top of that, there was a team you played for the second time. Did that play a factor as well?
I thought it did. We just came out usually how we always play. The rain was definitely a factor, but I don't think we let it get to our heads as much as we thought it would. It's always good to play a team twice. Brock told us this, that it helps us because they're going to come out at us differently than they did the first time. So it's nice to have to like handle that. So
moving to Sunday, obviously you got the win there. How was it to get that assist on the crossover to Hatcher?
It was awesome. It's always great to assist. It's always great to see a player like Hatcher score for our team. Brock has mentioned this, but she's always dangerous when she gets the ball, so it's nice that she gets rewarded with a goal, and I'm glad that I was able to do that for her. So,
the team had another strong second half. Is that something you made an emphasis of, or is it just kind of something that's happened?
Yeah, we've talked about it a lot, about going in the second half strong and starting out, well, both halves strong, but especially the second half. It just makes the game a lot easier for us rather than having to chase the game later on. So starting really well has helped us a lot.
You don't have any games this week. What's going to be your focus?
I think our focus this week will be to be better. I know it's considered an off week, but I think it's somewhere where we can better ourselves all around, whether that's rest, getting extra workouts, and then training really hard, all training sessions this week.
Brock, Friday, obviously, I talked about it with Bianca, but the messy game Friday, obviously with the rain conditions, but how'd you think the squad came out and played?
I thought we played well. I did. Disappointed we didn't find a way to win that game. I thought we created enough chances to do so. I thought we started great by getting an early goal. And really, I felt like we were able to get the ball into dangerous places a lot. You know, we had 30 shots on the night, which is really high. We've got to find a little bit better way to be more dangerous with some of those chances. I thought on Sunday we were a little bit better in front of goal, getting players in and around the box and challenging the goalkeeper and really being able to pick up some of those loose balls. I think that would have made the difference on Friday to be a little bit better inside the penalty area. Much like the goal we created that Nicole finished off.
Sunday, obviously a pretty good team that came in to a Fishback 6-2 team, but you really outshot them and kind of controlled that game, especially in the second half.
Yeah, I loved the energy we played with, loved how hard we played. I thought even in the first half we played pretty well. You know, the difference was a set piece, and that's soccer at times. But as we went into the locker room at halftime, I felt like we were still in a pretty good spot. We just needed to find a way to break them down, and we were getting chances to do so. So I was really, really happy that our team came out with even more energy in the second half and created a couple of nice goals.
What's on the agenda for the off week from games?
Yeah, it's just a chance for us to really step back and focus on the smaller pieces of development. We'll focus a little bit on the individual development. We'll focus a little bit on small group play. We won't do a ton of 11v11 stuff because it gives us this luxury of just being able to get better individually and in small group play. And oftentimes, those that's the difference in the game anyhow. So it gives us a really great opportunity to focus on those things.
Seven league play coming up, how do you get the team to switch focus from the knock-on games of really the individual development to this is when it really matters to get the seeding of conference play and then getting into the tournament and beyond?
Yeah, we talked with our leadership group yesterday about what's different from a conference standpoint. And everybody recognizes conference games are tougher. They're tougher. Teams have more tools to prepare for you. They've got more familiarity from the past, from playing them year after year after year. There's some rivalry involved. You've got targets based on the fact that we've won the tournament the last 3 years. And so we understand those challenges. And we understand that in certain ways, conference games are going to be the biggest challenge that we face just because of how tight they are. And most conference games are going to come down to a play here or there. And that's our focus, is to prepare to give our best in those moments.
A lot of new faces at the beginning of the year getting some playing time really have started to make an impact. What's it like to see those younger players, the new players, start to kind of click and figure out the college game?
Yeah, it's great. You know, I thought Leah had a great weekend, probably the best one she's had since she's been here as far as energy goes. Marissa and Rachel are giving us great energy off the bench in the attack. And then Katie Zabel's been a stud for us in the back. And we're playing her in different spots. You know, on Sunday she played as an outside back, and she's played as a center back for us. And she's been a really stable piece for us. And then it's great to see Taylor get some more experience in goal in the first half. All of those experiences are really valuable to their development.
To stay on last weekend a little bit, but off the field, you guys hosted Hometown Heroes. What did that mean to your program to be able to celebrate that day?
Yeah, it means a ton. And obviously, it's a small token we can do to really thank those people, the people that, you know, run into danger instead of away from it. Most of those people, as far as the fire department in Brookings, are volunteers. They're not paid, and so they do that. They just give their time to that cause. We had the fire chief speak to our team on Thursday. I thought that was great. His message was, you may not think you have anything to give, but you always have your time, and that's far more valuable than anything else you have to give. And so it was pretty impactful for our program. It really was. And it's our hope that I told our team this before the game, is let's just make sure that our effort today honors those people. That our effort honors those people. That's all we can do, and it fails in comparison to what they do every day. But at least we can make sure our effort honors them.